सर यहाँ पे
सर यहाँ पे
सर वन लास्ट सीक्रेट
सर बिल्कुल
सर वन लास्ट चलो क्या सर यहाँ
सर स्टेडी है सर सामने
एक्सक्यूज मी सर यहाँ पे
सर यहाँ पे
सेवन मोर स्टेट सर
सर यहाँ लास्ट कॉर्नर यहाँ सर यहाँ लास्ट
यस सर What is the steak?
Ribeye.
So yes, steak. So.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I welcome you all on this historic day. We have assembled here, as well as Mr. Polat Kakkar, to be here with us. The author of this publication, Sri Pradeep Chandra, has seen Aamir Khan from close quarters. It contains beautiful photographs, paintings, sketches, and unforgettable images that can be Satyameva Jayate bears testimony to that. There are a number of anecdotes. I'll better skip that one for Pradeepji to speak. And the evening, we are indeed indebted to all of you for coming over here. I am indebted to Pat Pedizza.
Whatever he has done, all the films that he has done have been very, very successful and different. Each film which he does, each director that he selects, they are not the best of directors or very successful ones.
Congratulations, Mr. Chandra, and congratulations, Nyogi Bose. Animal activist, editor, and maker of some of the best films, Mr. Pritesh Nandi, the man who has changed the pace of Indian cinema for it to pursue towards corporate excellence.
I don't know why I've been called to speak here. Like Aamir Khan, I prefer to keep my silence on such moments. This book is important because I have seen, I mean, Aamir Khan we all know about, so okay, I'm not going back into discussing Aamir Khan. Great actor, famous activist. He's done some remarkable movies, and he's a remarkable man. But this book is more about the man who's paid his tribute to Aamir Khan. It's about Pradeep Chandra, a man who has devoted all his life to quietly working behind the camera and catching the mood, the spirit, the beauty and the magic of the lives of people. I have seen Pradeep do some amazing, truly amazing photo essays in his time. There are not many magazines left which carry photo essays, and not many newspapers which do that anymore. So we are unlikely to see much of his work in a collective space. So his books now cover that space. So you have his book on Bachchan, you have his book on Hussein, and now you have his book on Aamir Khan. Each of these books speak about the quality of the man who is paying tribute. He has spent years pursuing their career, capturing that on celluloid and putting it together with the help of people who have known Aamir Khan in this case. These are people, as he said, himself confessed, he doesn't even know Aamir Khan all that well, which is fascinating. Photographer's life is doubly fascinating because he's capturing people, he's capturing images of these people, often without having access to their lives. And this book is therefore a very fascinating tribute by a photographer to a man he's admired over the years. I hope Pradeep keeps doing this. We don't see too many people working very hard on books anymore. The world has moved. The world has shifted to digital media. So it's important to have people like Pradeep who's doing this. It's much more important also to have people like Mr. Niyogi, who's publishing this. He's one of the most prolific publishers in the country today. And he publishes the most amazingly unusual books. And books on, he just produced a book on tea, he was telling me. I mean, I've seen him do books on the most esoteric and the most exotic of subjects, which most publishers would shy away from in today's world. So it is important that all of us give him a hand, because this is the kind of work that needs to be supported. I think Shaurya Shortcut Sarkar, who edited the book, deserves a special mention. I think people who have worked with Pradeep on the book deserve special mention, who have written stuff here like Rajat Sharma, Rauf Ahmed Uzair, and a whole lot of other people who contributed to the book. And I wish it all success. Thank you.
Well, as Mr. Bachchandra said, that it's very difficult to know Aamir Khan personally upfront and with insights, because he's such a private person, and there are so many facets to him which are so difficult to come. They come in little hints and glances, and because of Mr. Chandra's special art of keeping a very low-key camera, where he's all over the place and yet nowhere, that he captures moments of his subjects which give you an insight into the subject itself. And therefore, if you really want to know about Aamir and his sensitivities and what he's really all about, if you go through the book of photographs, a photograph says more in one frame than 1,000 words. So whatever anybody might describe Ahmed, they will be right and they'll still be wrong and they'll still be wanting. But I have a feeling that this book will actually satisfy most people who want to know a lot more about Aamir Khan the person, Aamir Khan the husband, Aamir Khan the actor, Aamir Khan the activist, you know, and Aamir Khan the achiever. Because at the end of the day, the reason why we all look at him and say, I can't stand the man, but by God, what achievement. You know, and he can be anal on detail, and none of us are, so therefore we tend to go around and say, why is he so anal about detail? And he'll look at you and he'll smile and say, the God is in the detail. So you'll find that different people who had different experiences with him will have very, very different stories to tell. But if you look at the photograph that Mr. Chandra has got in his book, then more or less tell 99% of the story if you choose to look carefully. So the first time you look at the book, you will only see the photographs and you will only see the captions and you say, oh, this is historical. He was with this, he was with this, he did this, he's with the children, he's with his uncle, he's with, you know, with Daftari, he's this, that. The second time you look at the book, you say, hey, there's another layer somewhere. And the third time you look at the book, you suddenly realize that there is a door opening into the secret life of Aamir Khan, which nobody actually knows, except the photographer. So when you read the book, remember, the minimum number of times that you read it is about 3 times. Because the first time you'll only see the facts. The second time you'll see, hey, there's a shadow. And the third time, there's a window that'll open for you. So remember, that book is going to lie on your shelf, gathering dust for a long period of time. So every now and then, you'll come and visit it. Because every time you visit it, it'll show you something new. And especially with the man as he's going on, the way he is, because I personally think that he's going to eventually grow up to be a great director, much more than an actor, frankly. Because his tendencies, his instincts, his attention to detail, and his understanding of the medium is so vast, because he reads so much about it, he experiences so much about it, he comes from a film family, which is almost 3 generations deep, and therefore a lot of his knowledge is actually DNA. And the business of film evolves faster than its audience. Because if you are behind your audience, then your film flops. Because been there, done that, seen this, seen that. So it looks like a Me Too copy. So for Aamir to be so successful that every time he's presented a film, through its instinct, he knows that it's one jump ahead of his audience. And that the audience looks at it and says, this is the benchmark. This is the standard for the rest of the industry. And the moment he does that, he can then go back and retire. And the next time that he's competing with an audience's introspection, his hope, it's whatever it is, it's not against that. It's against his own abilities to what he's done the last time. So he's really competing against himself every single time, because every time he makes a film, there's something about it that's unique. Whether it's the marketing, whether it's the intensity, whether it's the instinct, whether it's the subject, whether it's the depth, and whether it's the detail. Now, one thing that if anybody has any hopes of working with Aamir, you have to get used to the fact that he will interfere in everything if he's not happy. If he's happy with your explanation of what you want to do, he will not touch it. But if he's unhappy and if he asks you a question about it, believe me, he will not let it go. It doesn't matter, he'll pick up a phone at 3 in the morning and call you and say, you know, I'm not happy about what we talked about today. Can we do something about it? Can we postpone the shoot? Can we cancel tomorrow's shoot because I'm not really ready? And why isn't he ready? Because he's not happy with the scene. Because there's something bothering him. And most of the time he's actually right. So we hate him for that, but we love him because it eventually comes out okay. So when I worked with Aamir, it was historical because I did the first ad film that he ever did in his life. And he said, I've never done an ad film before. So I said, so there's always the first ad. So he said, what is the script? So I said, I'll show you the film. We're actually copying a film from Michael J. Fox's. So it was called NG, it was for Pepsi. And he looked at it and he loved it and he said, it's a great film. but you'll have to Indianize it. I said, yeah, that's why we have. I said, because it's a great amount of tax responsibility, because if you do it properly, everybody will turn around and not give you credit and say you copied it. And if you don't do it properly, this is what a bunch of assholes, you couldn't even copy it. So, to him, that's the pressure that you're going to have. So he said, who are you casting as the two girls in the film? So I said, I'll let you know, but we're still in the process. And the other part that is historical, it was also Aishwarya Rai's first ever real project. So we cast her as Sanju, and we cast Mahima, who was, not Mahima, she was, she had another name. As the pardon?
Kavita.
No. Ritu. Correct. That's correct. She was a planter's daughter from Darjeeling, and her name was Ritu at that time. And she did the girl next door, and Aishwarya played the bombshell. And forever it changed the whole business of the name Sanju, because everyone said, from 8 to 80, I got phone calls saying, who is Sanju? And she was there exactly for 3 seconds in the film. But I remember one particular episode, it was a shot that he was happy. He opens the door and he looks at the girl and he says, yes, and he's interested. But at the same time, he can't be overtly lecherous, because she's a pretty little thing and she's the neighbor next door. And she says, I'm the neighbor next door and I was wondering if you had a layer of Pepsi. And he says, now he doesn't want you to go away. He doesn't have a, he thinks he has a layer of Pepsi. He wants her to come into his house, and he doesn't know how to say so, without looking safe. So it's like ringing a doorbell, seeing a young man who gets boing and with banana eyes, he'll never go into his house. So he had to really underplay that shot. And he was a little unhappy about it at that time. So he said, you know, can we do the shot again? I'm not very happy about it. I said, sure, if he doesn't come out well, we'll take it. So we edited the film, it was fine. So I showed it to Vivarishi, who was a client, and she said, wow, let's release it tomorrow. It's looking so good. So she rings up Amir from Delhi, where we have a meeting. He's like, Amir, congratulations. You've done a great job in the film. And there's dead silence on the other side. She, hello, hello, are you there? She says, yes. She says, what's wrong? He says, Pralhad promised to change the shot. So what do you mean it's ready and it's going on air? I mean, I haven't seen it. And I don't like the shot and I want to change it. So please don't do anything. So Vibhavati said, yeah, yeah, talk to him. So I said, yeah, what is it, Amit? So he says, you didn't change the shot. So I said, no, because it's okay. I told you that if it was okay, it would do. He said, no, I have to see it. I'm not convinced. I said, Amit, it's my film more than it's your bloody film. Okay? You're just a passenger in it. So it's my reputation also. So you at least trust somebody. So he said, yeah, I don't know whether I trust you, but show me the film. So I rang up my wife. I told her, take the damn film, take it to the editing room, and show it to her. He was editing something at that time. So he sat there and watched it about 30 times for that one shot. I don't know what he was watching. Then he called some friends and said, what do you think of this? He said, wow, it's terrific. So he said, yeah, okay. So that's Amir for you. So at the end of it, I mean, of course, you got a lot of kudos. It was a really natural brand. I think historically, it made Pepsi the brand that it is, because that is the beginning of the journey. So the book and Mr. Chandra and the unobtrusive lens. That's a secret word. I think you should read this. Not just read the book, but look at the photographs very carefully. Thank you.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and obviously thank you all very much for being here. I'd like to also thank this very distinguished panel. Supradeep Chandra, who's put this... I haven't had a look at the book yet, but I'm sure it's really, really good, because everybody has said so. Considering we have a few fairly cynical people on the panel and they've praised it, then I'm sure it's going to be very good. But of course, a lot of kudos and a lot of compliments to Mr. Chandra for putting this book together. I'm pretty certain that wasn't an easy thing to do. But as far as Aamir Khan goes, I mean, I think I found his journey particularly fascinating, because I've had the good fortune, which I can say now, I mean, at the time, I didn't know if it was going to be good fortune or not. But I had the good fortune of working with him in his very first film, which was called Kayamat Se Kayamat Tak. And I remember when Mr. Nasir Hussain, who was his uncle, called me to his office, which was opposite Behboob Studios at the time, And he began, when I walked into his office, I looked to the right of me and I saw three people sitting there. There was a lady who turned out to be Nusrat, who is today the actor Aamir Khan's mother. And next to him was sitting the director, who was of course Mansoor Khan. And next to them was sitting this very fair, cherubic looking boy with one eyebrow. So anyway, I said, they're all looking at me very sort of intensely, thank you. And also a little skeptically, I suppose, to say like, you know, so I came and Nasir Saab began to tell me the story. It just got to the first, to the prologue part, but I said, yeah, I'll do it. I mean, you know, to sort of knock off the groom. The 12-bore gun in the first sequence is something that everybody looks forward to, I'm sure. So I said, yeah, perfect. That's perfectly dynamic for me. I'll take the part. And there began the process. And I think at that time when we started shooting, everybody was new. And there was a story about the way we were cast for it, because Nasir Saab actually had planned the Qayamat Se Qayamat Tak with the great and legendary Mr. Shami Kapoor and the great and legendary Mr. Sanjeev Kumar, but Nasir Saab himself was a little unwell, and his doctors advised him not to take on a project of such magnitude with all these major stars. So he offered it to Mansoor, and Mansoor did it, and said the only reason and the only way that I'm going to do this picture is that if, you know, I cannot work with, in the sense that I cannot, with my level that I am, I cannot direct people like Shami Kapoor and you know, Mr. Sanjeev Kumar, so I have to have a completely new cast. And I'm very grateful for that statement, because that's how I got Qayamat Se Qayamat Tak, because I don't think I would have been there had it not been for that. So we began, and actually my first impression, by the way, before we go any further, I have to tell you that I take full credit and full claim for suggesting to Aamir very, very long ago, in fact the first film, to knock off that little bit in the middle of his set, to separate his eyebrows. So if I think he has achieved a lot of fame and fortune through that suggestion, but that's something we'll talk about some other day. But what I noticed about him at that stage itself, as Pralad mentioned, you know, he was, for a person who was just starting out as a leading man, he was so committed to the film, he was so committed to every single shot, how the other actors were working. And I've never called that interference. I've always respected that as a commitment to improving and to being able to suggest and to make something possibly better. And that is one thing that about him, is that why he wants, the reason why he always likes to have a certain kind of actor working with him, is because he feels it's a collaborative effort. And I have to tell you that from that day, I mean from the time that he began in Qayamat Se Qayamat Tak, he was always in the huddle with Mansoor. And you know, there was always discussions about how this shot should be done or how something would be. He used to always come to me. And he used to talk to me about the relationship, because I was playing his father in that. And I found that, you know, in the beginning you get the feeling that, you know, he has a little upstart, because, well, he comes from as people said, from the family of filmmakers, so perhaps he just thinks it's his sort of, you know, his sort of birthright to come and talk to people about how things should be done, or suggest, perhaps, collaboratively how a scene should be done. But you get over that immediately, because he is very genuine about what he's talking about. He is extremely keen that a scene work the way it should, and this is from his first film, not from the legend that he has become now. And I watched that growth, and actually I'm very fascinated, and today I can say that I'm proud to have worked with him in that first film. I used to be, the other thing is to, which I always tell Aamir, was I said, you know, as a character actor, I think I'm the only person who signed more autographs than you. Because during Qayamat Se Qayamat Tak shooting, nobody knew who the heck he was. I was sitting there signing autographs and you know, they'd say, who's the hero of this film? So I'd say, this boy with the pink cheeks. So they'd say, oh wow, and they began to take his autograph. So, you know, so I have sort of, in a way, contributed to his fame and glory. So, well, you know, everybody knows about him. He's an amazing person, and I won't go on and on about it, except that to relate to you a few these moments that we had together in his first film. And I've, over the years, I've always heard that, you know, he interferes, he's got his hand in everything. And I say, why not? Because he has the experience, he has the commitment, and to me, he's a person who tries to achieve and to get the best out of a situation. And for that, I really admire him. I also admire Mr. Pradeep Chandra for going through this. I know he's a difficult person to deal with. It's not, you can't just walk up to him and start taking photos of him. So I really commend Mr. Chandra for all his effort. And I'm certain that that this book is going to be a very valuable coffee table book to all of you. And thank you very much for inviting me here to speak. And I hope you all have a wonderful evening. Thank you.